Joining us now, Congressman David Schweikert, representing Arizona's 6th District in Washington. David, thanks for joining us by telephone here on America's Forum.
No, and always enjoy it, J.D.
I know there's a big difference. What's the maxim in politics? Listen to what they say, but watch what they do. Do you have confidence that, in fact, the Obama administration will send these children home and not give them deferred deportation?
Well, actually, I have no idea how this president looks himself in the mirror in the morning, considering how duplicitous their promises, their speeches. Look, and J.D., I think you and I even talked about this months ago, that we were seeing something scary, something happening in the border crossing numbers. Back January, we knew something was happening. And this administration pretended nothing, avoided it, didn't want to talk about it. Look, and for the listeners, they should all know that J.D. and I have been friends for a long time. He was my congressman, now I'm his. We're being told that you can pick up a newspaper in El Salvador and literally see printed advertisements from coyotes on saying, get across the U.S. border, and you can become an anchor and be able to bring the rest of your family. Are you telling me our embassies, our consulates in Central America don't read the local papers, haven't been reacting, haven't been correcting this information? So I'm incredibly cynical that this has been going on since the beginning of the year, and now the president is finally going to react to it?
Well, speaking of the president, David, you wrote him a letter, and in that letter, you said that you got right to the point in the letter, saying, quote, you're writing today to demand the immediate deployment of the National Guard to our southwest border to stem the flow of illegal immigrants crossing that border. And you have put a bill in the hopper. That's right, the legislation you have, the Southwest Border Protection Act of 2014. Two questions, David. First, briefly tell us what the bill would do, and also on the National Guard, couldn't Arizona Governor Jan Brewer and Texas Governor Rick Perry, couldn't they call out the Guard by their own order?
They could call out the Guard, but there's the ability for them to actually work with the Border Patrol. If we go back to Operation Jumpstart in 2006 and 2008, when I believe 6,000 National Guard members were put into auxiliary roles to shore up our Border Patrol. So in some ways, this isn't new intellectual capital. This has been done before. I'm requesting 10,000 right now because we're having conversations with Arizona Border Patrol agents telling us that some of their best trackers, some of their best folks are now providing social services at these detention facilities to children. We need to shore up our border presence. But as you know, this is only a small portion of the solution. We need to change the information that's down in Central America. We need Mexico to actually keep its treaty obligations with the United States instead of allowing these waves. We need the truth on how many people are losing their lives, are being literally sold into exploitation as they're moving across these countries, across Mexico. This is actually, it's both heartbreaking, it's a humanitarian crisis, and it's also a crisis in the standpoint that we're going to lose our sovereignty unless we can demonstrate that our borders mean something.
David, along those lines, let's turn now to a column you co-wrote with your colleagues Matt Salmon and Paul Gosar. It appeared in the Arizona Republic back in 2013, I believe May 1st of that year. In part in that column, you say, and I quote, there is no benefit to keeping 11 million illegal immigrants trapped in the shadows. It is in our country's interest to know who they are and where they live. Reforming our immigration system to address the status of the 11 million people in our country illegally should focus on normalizing their legal status without access to federal benefits or a special pathway to citizenship. David, you and I have both heard from Arizonans concerned with that particular language in that column appearing in the Arizona Republic, specifically about normalizing the legal status of those who have come here illegally. They're saying, in essence, that is amnesty. How would you respond to that?
Yeah, and I think anyone that's going to use that word amnesty on that discussion obviously isn't thinking through the process. For the three members in Congress, we know we have 11-plus million here. How do I get them to sign up for a sponsored work visa that has an expiration date? So I know who they are, I know where they are, I know they are not able to tap our welfare benefits, and when that visa expires, they have the obligation to head home.
Congressman Schweiker, John Bachman here sitting alongside J.D. I want to focus again back on that word normalizing. So I'm taking what you're saying here. That means taking the prospect of deportation off the table, correct?
Oh, no. If they haven't found a sponsored workplace visa, they're still subject to deportation.
But if they go through with the normalization process as you see it, that in effect would take the deportation aspect of this off the table.
Well, if they've gone through the mechanics, and obviously the mechanics aren't laid out yet, and so you have someone, a welder, he's already working right now undocumented or illegally, and that company's willing to sponsor him for a 3-year work visa. At least at this point, I know who it is, I know they're not getting benefits they should not be receiving, and I also know there's an expiration date where they're obligated to go back to their home country and start all over again.
David, there's both the long-term process and the short-term here and now with the flood of illegals who happen to be minors. We've got the breakdown on what the feds want to spend to deal with this flood of minors crossing our border right now. The Department of Health and Human Services, according to Senator Barbara Mikulski from the Appropriations Committee, they want to spend over $2 billion in housing and feeding. And of course, we know that there are 47,000 unaccompanied minors coming into our country from Central America via Mexico. Go ahead.
That's all that's coming now. We saw, J.D., there's some published data from yesterday that the expectation of the next 12 months could be 120,000.
And as you said that, those numbers came up on the screen. Now, something else happened in Washington yesterday on the Senate side, a hearing, an exchange between Senator Ted Cruz of Texas and the new Secretary of Homeland Security, Jay Johnson. I want you to listen to the exchange, then we'll get your reaction. Here it is from yesterday.
Mr. Secretary, my time is expiring, but with all respect, in my view, that argument is a red herring. That argument explains why we've seen an increase in Central American immigration, to be sure, because of the problems and challenges those nations are facing. But it doesn't explain the unaccompanied minors. In 2011, 15% of the OTMs of the other than Mexicans apprehended were unaccompanied minors. In 2014, that number's grown to 37%. There's nothing about the violence in Central America that would cause people to be handing over their children, little girls and little boys.
So your take, David, on what Senator Ted Cruz had to say to Secretary Johnson?
Oh, well, it's the obvious point. Look, if the world works on incentives and you can pick up a newspaper in El Salvador and it's being said, if you can get one of your family members, particularly children, across the border, they will be given a legal status where they get to stay and eventually will get citizenship and eventually they'll be able to bring you and the rest of your family up north across the border, what do you think is going to happen? And this is a classic case of not law of unintended consequences. This is a law of obvious consequences. When you create public policy, as this president has done with his pen and his telephone, what did he think was going to happen?
And to that, on that line of thinking, David, the concern for a lot of people, you may share it, it goes back to trying to draft bills with this administration. If this administration is not going to enforce existing law, what makes you think they're going to enforce any new law?
Oh, you don't. There's absolutely no trust. But we are now going to have to accept the fact that the current immigration law we're operating under is written in a way where it gives far, far too much discretion, weasel room, wiggle room, I guess would be the where a president can pretend to get enough lawyers in a room and pretend to make up policy. We're going to have to rewrite a substantial portion of our immigration law so we can never have a president again. can just make the rules up as they go.
David Schweikert, Republican member of Congress from Arizona's 6th District, we thank you for your time. We'll monitor the progress of your legislation, and we look forward to having you back on America's Forum.
Thank you, J.D.
So you heard David Schweikert, his skepticism about the administration, the continued flood of illegals crossing our southern border. Your comments are welcomed. Why don't you tweet us those comments at Newsmax TV, hashtag America's Forum. There's also email and Facebook, and we're coming right back.